Let's do another quiz about history predictors. Let's say we have a program in which we have two nested loops. One I goes from 0 through 7, and then within it we have a nested loop of j goes from 0 through 7. Let's say we do something that doesn't have much branching behavior in it. This type of nested loop structure is very common when you have things like matrices or even image processing. In particular, for image processing, it's very common that, for example, compression or decompression are working in blocks of, let's say, 8 by 8 pixels in this case, which will mean that there are loops like this all over the code. Let's say that the code, when it does this nested loop, just does something else and then very quickly comes back to it to do another round of this. So this is not just executed once, the whole thing is executed many, many times. If we are building a history-based predictor that should do well on this code, it needs at least how many entries, and each of these entries should have how many bits of history, and how many 2-bit counters do we need per entry as a result of this history.